doctors. I am Dr. L. Mahadevan from a village in Kanyakumari district practicing Ayurveda. I studied Ayurveda thoroughly. Then I had an opportunity to study Hutchison, Davidson and Harrison thoroughly. But I am not using any modern drugs in my practice. But I am using technologies and clinical methods in my practice to document the case. And we have got a good practice in a small village. So we are doing Ayurveda without any this commercial outlook. So we treat around 3,000 intervertebral disc cases with sciatica problem. So I am going to present two case studies. The one is on reabsorption of intervertebral disc, a clinical possibility through Vasti Chikitsa. Everybody in your life would have experienced low back pain. Many times when you do MRI, Kapha as per Ayurveda. So we in our principle give Ushnam Anulomana Chikitsa, and cleaning the colon is the main therapy, which is called Anulomana. Anulomana brings the balance of autonomic nervous system. So the Anulomana Chikitsa is found to be effective in very challenging intervertebral disc cases. Now we will go to the case. A 36-year-old man involved in bank work came with LBA, sciatica, left leg. The presentation is acute, duration 10 days. The patient experienced intermittent back pain, and the patient had neurological claudication. He was unable to sit for more than 30 minutes. And 2 weeks ago, he developed a severe acute low back pain and had left sciatica with paresthesia in the left foot and a cold feeling in the left foot. He is found lumbar spine. Actually, he had compensated scoliosis pain, unable to walk. The conventional pain management was a failure. So as the conventional management was a failure, we took MRI. MRI is available for 2,000 rupees in the center. So the desiccated disc with bulged annulus seen at L4, L5 level, desiccated left para centrally excruted disc seen in the L5, S1 level. Thecal sac compression is there. We have been working on this a lot. Now what you are seeing is the sagittal view, because the presentation is only 7 minutes. You are in the sagittal view, you are able to see the disc protrusion. Now we will see the axial view. The axial view, you have having the severe protrusion, compressing the neural foramen. And it is a clinical sciatica, occlusion of neural foramen on the right side with the mild neural foramen impingement on the right side. This MRI report is taken. Desiccated disc with bulged annulus with type 3 annular tear at L4, L5 level. Left paracentrally extruded disc at L5, S1 causing thecal and nerve, left nerve root compression. Then, Ayurvedically speaking, we have given a purgation, Gandharvastadikashayam, Sakadaradikashayam, Vaishwanarachurnam, and Yerandamuladi Niruga Vasti. Vasti is a thing which work on gut-brain mechanism. Once we give a Vasti, we have found that the serotonin increases. Mood also changes after Vasti. There are a lot of neurologists here to understand Ayurveda can be talked in a mythological term, it can be talked in a neurophysiological terms. The country is called Bharata. Bharata is Bhava, Raga and Thala. Bhava is expression, Raga is emotion, Thala is rhythm. That is Vada Pitta Kapha. That is why this country is called Bharata. This Vada Pitta Kapha is called Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. In neurological perspective, Vada is, dopamine can be brought under Vada, serotonin can be brought under Pitta, GABA can be brought under Kapha. In a cell, if you take a cell, if you take a cell, in the cell, the nucleus is Vada, the mitochondria is Pitta, the protoplasm is Kapha. So in Ayurvedically, we study Vada, Pitta, Kapha in one level. Once you study physiology, once you study modern medicine, whatever the medicine you name it, you will be able to see the whole Jagat, the whole manifestation, whole universe as three forces, generation, operation and destruction. This Vada, Pitta, Kapha is controlled by or understood by sympathetic and parasympathetic activities. The Vegas, the natural urges told in Ayurveda, are nothing but parasympathetic activities. Now after that, we give Anulomanam, this Ayurvedic doctors know. The total cost for the IVDP management is 4,000 rupees for 20 days. So after this, the MRI was taken again, which showed that there was a complete reabsorption of a disc protrusion. Now, many papers have written stating that prolapsed disc material has been reabsorbed by conventional management, including rest, not only Ayurveda, but Ayurveda quickened the process. Now you see the second MRI taken. you cannot see the protrusion here in the L5-S1 level. Now you see the lateral view, you see the foramen. You see. Now you see the original document, doctor report given by the radiologist. Comparing to the previous MRI, Saju, how to put the previous one? Yeah, comparing to the previous MRI, the L5-S1 prolapse and the left lateral recess encroachment showed significant regression. We are doing this for most of the cases without bladder involvement, cauda equina, producing pyramidal signs, if it is lumbar myelopathy, if there is a foot drop, all other cases can be managed successfully by Vasti. Vasti, if you are seeing a big balloon in a room, after 10 days you don't touch the balloon, you enter the balloon shrinks in its shape. Likewise, intervertebral disc reabsorption and rehydration is a possibility once the vata anulomana, apana prana flows in its proper way. And apana anulomana chikisa includes diet, exercise. There are certain asanas that can be done. Every asana, lumbar flexion has to be avoided. Flexion increases the problem. Extension can be given. With this, in massage also, we should avoid flexion and extension is given. So this we are doing 20 days including food and accommodation. The treatment is only 4,000 rupees. I don't know how the corporate and other things will be benefited by this.